गुड आफ्टरनून स्टूडेंट्स. टुडे वी आर गोइंग टू डिस्कस अबाउट द क्रीप ऑफ द रेल्स. क्रीप इफ इट अकर्स फॉर अ लॉन्गर पीरियड इट कैन रिड्यूस द लाइफ ऑफ द रेल. फर्स्ट ऑफ ऑल व्हाट इज क्रीप. क्रीप इज डिफाइंड एज द लॉन्गिट्यूडनल मूवमेंट ऑफ द रेल विद रिस्पेक्ट टू द ट्रैफिक और द स्लीपर्स. रेल हैव अ टेंडेंसी टू ग्रेजुअली मूव इन द डायरेक्शन ऑफ डोमिनेंट ट्रैफिक. ट्रैफिक बेसिकली इन द लॉन्गिट्यूडनल डायरेक्शन. क्रीप इज कॉमनली इन केस ऑफ द रेलवे ट्रैक बट इट्स मैग्नीट्यूड वेरीज कंसिडरेबली फ्रॉम प्लेस टू प्लेस. डिपेंड्स अपॉन द वॉल्यूम ऑफ द ट्रैफिक एज वेल एज द टाइम पीरियड फॉर विच द वॉल्यूम इज प्लेस्ड ऑन द रेल. The theories which are based upon the creep are, first one is the wave motion theory. In this theory, it has been discussed the wavy motion has been created due to the moving load which is causing deflection in the rail under the load. The portion of the rail immediately under the wheel gets slightly depressed due to the wheel load. Therefore, rail generally have a wavy formation. The second one is the percussion theory. Percussion theory is based upon the when the rail is moving on when the traffic is moving on the joint, particularly in the forward direction. According to the percussion theory, creep is developed due to the impact of the wheel at the rail and ahead of a joint. As the wheel of the moving train leaves the trailing rail at the joint, the nail get pushed forward, causing it to the move joint longitudinally in the direction of the traffic, and therefore causing the creep. So basically this is due to the moving of the traffic in a forward direction. Drag theory is basically opposite to the percussion theory. According to the drag theory, the backward thrust of the driving wheels of a locomotive has a tendency to push the rail backward, while the thrust of the other wheel of the locomotive and the trailing wagon pushes the rail in the direction of which the locomotive is moving. So resulting in the again in a longitudinal direction, but it is due to the backward motion of the rail. These are the causes of the creep. Basically the ironing effect of the wheel, the starting and stopping operations, the whenever the train is slowing down or halted, and the change in temperature, unbalanced traffic. So the creep when occurs basically can reduce the carrying capacity of the rail gauges. In the single line sections, even though the traffic moves in both directions, the volume of traffic in each direction is normally variable. So poor maintenance of the track can also lead to the creep. When creep is exceeding 150 mm, resulting in maintenance problem, the same could be adjusted by pulling the rails back. So the creep adjuster can be applied. A creep adjuster is normally used when extensive work is involved. The creep adjuster is set at the center of the length of the track to be tackled, with the wide joints behind and the jams ahead of it. Thanks.